We periodically get a flood of emails on a specific topic, and I guess it relates to how popular a specific clip is on YouTube at the time. But we've had a couple of people write to us promoting their favorite conspiracy theory. So I want to give you some examples of some stuff we get in email. And a big one is 9/11 was an inside job, and the proof is that the U.S. government has previously engaged in conspiracy theories. Okay, plus Zeitgeist. Okay. Christianity is a big conspiracy designed to keep everyone in line. The leaders of the major religions all know this, but they're sworn to secrecy. And Zeitgeist. I see a theme. And HIV.
Find me sitting at this table. This is a response video to Galen and Gustav, a message from a Zeitgeist member to the atheist community. I really appreciate this video. I agree with you. I echo your frustrations as well. The thrust of his video is explaining to people who are unfamiliar the fact that the Zeitgeist movement is not the same thing as Zeitgeist the movie, and it does not take its assertions or interpretations as any of its founding tenets. You can fundamentally disagree with the entire movie, and you haven't even touched upon what the Zeitgeist movement is, what it means, and what its tenets are. I'm going to put a link below that's going to take you to the Zeitgeist movement website. It's going to take you to something called the knowledge base, question number 6. Is the Zeitgeist movement related to Peter Joseph's films? The answer is, while the word Zeitgeist is also associated with Peter Joseph's films, Zeitgeist the movie and Zeitgeist Addendum, film series-based content isn't to be confused with the tenets of the Zeitgeist movement here. Now, I'm not going to go over what the Zeitgeist movement is about right now because that would burn too much fuel, that would take ages. I'm actually just going to drive home the point that they're not the same thing. Yes, I empathize and I understand why you would make this mistake. After all, the filmmaker is the same guy who set up the movement and it uses the same name. But it is absolutely not the case that, you know, therefore the Zeitgeist movement actually takes the same assumptions and assertions as some kind of founding tenet or driving direction that are presented in Zeitgeist the movie. It's also true for Zeitgeist Addendum, although there are overlaps considerably with that in regards to the discussion of a resource-based economy. Zeitgeist the movie started out as, in fact, an artistic expression from Peter Joseph that was not even designed originally as a movie. It caught on, he released it on the internet and people could access it, and he started to make upgrades. It really, really caught on and caught the public's attention. But at the end of the day, you do not have to agree with anything presented in it in regards to what you would also assume in regards to the Zeitgeist movement. I myself disagree with many aspects put forward in Zeitgeist the movie, and it is not an important movie to me in regards to the discussion of a resource-based economy at all. Of course, Zeitgeist the movie discusses various academic things that need to be discussed within a sphere of analyzing data. And an academic discussion of such things as astrotheology, paganism, the emergence of monotheistic religion in the Middle East, and of course interpretations of the event 9/11. These are issues that I don't actually necessarily agree with Peter Joseph's interpretations that he's put forward in this movie. As far as I know, he's released a newer version with an accompanying ebook. Perhaps he writes certain mistakes that I believe he's made, but at the end of the day, this doesn't actually matter and does not ipso facto follow as a criticism to the Zeitgeist movement because, and I'm going to keep repeating this, it is not a founding tenet, it is not a founding assumption of the movement itself. These are two very, very different things. Zeitgeist the movie puts forward certain assertions about religion in regards to paganism and hero myths and messiah mythology. I think that there are certain points that he gets incorrect there. I think that he might have corrected some of them. At the same time, I disagree with the train of thought that clearly represents Christianity emerging from that process as directly as he implies. I feel so near to the howling of the winds. I feel so near to the crashing of the waves. I feel so near to the flowers in the fields. I feel so near. I feel so near to the howling of the winds. I
feel so near to the crashing of the waves. I feel so near to the flowers in the fields. I feel so near to the howling of the winds. I feel so near to the crashing of the waves. I feel so near to the flowers in the
I'm absolutely willing to discuss this with people. It's an academic issue. It's an interesting thing. We're now talking about the history of religion. We're not talking about the Zeitgeist movement. In regards to 9/11, this is also a very deep issue that has a lot of contentions in regards to it. There are a lot of different theories. There are a lot of different assertions put forwards. I take a position of healthy agnosticism and skepticism, where I say I'm not entirely convinced by the official explanation, and I say that the NIST report is not actually complete in regards to discussing the behavior of the collapse of the towers. However, I am more than willing for people to come forward and explain to me why I'm absolutely wrong. I don't take the assertion that 9/11 was per se an inside job. I say I don't know what went on. Like a lot of people who've looked at this and are truly open-minded, I say I have no fucking idea. But at the same time, my main thrust in regards to 9/11 is that what they need to do is they need to put forwards as many peer-reviewed scientific papers as they possibly can, that informs the public, that discusses these issues in a complete way, and that takes on these issues in a scientific manner. And so until this happens, I will remain entirely skeptical, and I will not take either side on either issue. I will remain essentially an agnostic. Again, this is not an issue related to the Zeitgeist movement itself, and whatever position you take on that is rather irrelevant to it. Of course, the third part of Zeitgeist, the movie, discusses certain political economic implications, which also in themselves can be debated and discussed, which are not important as founding tenets or assumptions or points of direction for the Zeitgeist movement itself. The reason that this is a big concern is people take this assumption and they write off the Zeitgeist movement and they see them as interchangeable, these issues, and they see the movie as the same thing as the movement, and this is absolutely false. Now, recently I wrote a response post on a blog of the Atheist Experience in which they wrote about a flood of Zeitgeist emails that are enthusing about Zeitgeist the movie. Now, they disagree with Zeitgeist the movie, as I do, for reasons that I've just discussed. But at the end of the day, they've made a big mistake. This is what Galen and Gustav was talking about in his video, and this is what I'm echoing right now. They've accidentally, unintentionally conflated Zeitgeist the movie with something called the Zeitgeist movement. And they've done this themselves in their own blog, and you'll see my response that I give to them here. Now, they give a list of different emails where they quote people who are saying, check out Zeitgeist the movie, it's amazing, it's so great. And they're showing these as examples of the kind of flood of emails they've received and how frustrating it is to receive these, because after all, they really don't agree with Zeitgeist the movie. However, the very first email that they put up, as I'll show here, is a guy who is not enthusing about Zeitgeist the movie. He's actually talking in this quote about the Zeitgeist movement. He says, well, the main point of the email is to tell you about the Zeitgeist movement. You may have heard about it, you may not. I just want to bring more awareness. It's very clear to me that they don't know what the Zeitgeist movement is, and this guy at the end of the day meant well. Unfortunately, he's been misinterpreted, and he's now had this email made public in a kind of gesture of ridicule. Now, I love the Atheist Experience. I watch that show. I've learned a lot from it, and I agree with their general criticisms of Zeitgeist the movie, and I think that this is an innocent mistake that they've made, and they've looked at the word Zeitgeist and they've done exactly what Galen and Gustav's talking about, exactly what I'm talking about. Here's my response below. I want to draw your attention to a mistake you've made on this thread. The first email you quote references something called the Zeitgeist movement. I find it unlikely that you actually know what this is, since it's not about the movie Zeitgeist, but is the activism arm of an organization known as the Venus Project. This is a different issue, a different topic of discussion entirely, yet you referenced it right at the top. I'd make an educated guess that you haven't heard of the Venus Project, Jacques Fresco and a resource-based economy. I'd rather the movement did not have the name Zeitgeist at the beginning of it, for this exact reason that it will be synonymous or fungible in regards to the Zeitgeist movie, complete with its religious and 9/11 assertions I do not ascribe to. Now, the last bit there might sound a little bit controversial to Zeitgeist movement members and advocates because I've essentially referenced, you know, how it might be a good thing to change the name. I actually like the name Zeitgeist. I like how it sounds. I like what it means, and it has name recognition, all these kinds of positive things. I also have my issues with it, which this video hopefully will put forwards. It's unintentional. So I'm not saying wouldn't it be great to change the name. I'm just making the point that, you know, if these mistakes continue, we've got a problem here. But anyway, I'll continue with the response. You end by saying, seriously, guys, Zeitgeist sucks. Fair enough, I'm not in love with it myself, nor do I agree with many aspects. I encourage you to find a better email to place at the top, since Zeitgeist the movie is not the Zeitgeist movement. If you're interested in putting forward correct information, not misinforming people, being misinformed yourselves, and intellectual honesty in general, you should really do that. I watch your show every week, so I am well aware you want to be as well informed on issues you take on as possible. This top email indicates that you are not entirely informed on the Zeitgeist movement. I'm not enthusing about the Zeitgeist movement and saying you should check it out. I'm pointing out a mistake that you have actually made, probably unwittingly as you represent things honestly. I think this is an innocent mistake on your part. I'm simply leaving this message to correct a mistake and help you. Other than that, forever keep your gloves off and have at it, because I love you Texans. So that is my response to Galen and Gustav and this general topic. I hope this is now clear to people, and I encourage you to check out the link that I put there, and hopefully we can move on from this. Thank you. The system grew up in a very different time, but all it does now is fuel difference and crime. Last time I checked, it was 2010, and not a damn thing now is like it was back then. So step up to the plate, friend. Patiently we wait, friend. Don't give in to hate, friend. We can make life great, friend. But you gotta take a stand. Welcome to the project, not a social reject, just a man in respect, cause it's all wrecked. Welcome to the project, heading on a new trek, no time for nothing, he's trying to come next. Welcome to the project, not a social reject, just a man in respect, cause it's all wrecked. Welcome to the project, heading on a new trek, no time for nothing, he's trying to come next. Welcome to the project, not a social reject, just a man in respect, cause it's all wrecked. Welcome to the project, heading on a new trek, no time for nothing, he's trying to come next.